Hey guys, welcome to another weekly market outlook on this channel. In today's video, of course, another breakdown of euro dollar, pound dollar, and Aussie dollar. So with that said, let's dive straight in. So starting off with euro dollar. Euro dollar is of course still in a bullish trend. Overall, if we look at the daily, we had this swing low, higher high, higher low, higher high. Since taking out this high over here, we have of course kind of seen a fake out on that high, push down in towards the downside. At the moment, if we look at euro dollar from a daily perspective, preferably we would want to see a reversal from this area of supply being the most strongest area of supply. However, overall, if we look at supply and demand, this of course is your area of supply, with this pretty much being the buy before the big sell-off in towards the downside. So there's a lot of supply located inside of this pivot of the overall buy to sell. However, overall, there's also a lot of pretty much like sell side supply from this wick all the way up in towards this high, hence why we reacted initially in towards the downside. So this could pretty much just be kind of like taking out the last sellers before, let's say, dumping further in towards the downside. However, highest probability shorts would be from this area of supply. However, why am I talking about sells? Well, the main reason being is that there's not a lot of, let's say, demand left within the market. Overall, if we look at pretty much this trend in towards the upside, it's very important to take into consideration what the overall order flow is. So what is order flow? It pretty much just showcases or visualizes where demand and supply is located in the market. So exactly here on your dollar, what we can see is that, let's say this is your order flow. So this sell before the big buy, then we can see pretty much that retracement back in towards the sell before the buy, and then a further push in towards the highs. Then again, sell before the buy, as we can see, big sell off, big buy, moves out of this area of demand, moves back in, and then moves back up in towards the highs. So pretty much this area of demand has been mitigated. Then again, this area of demand has been mitigated, and this is pretty much the only fresh area of demand that is left. So this area of daily demand, so this sell for the big buy, this should stay intact if we want to see still further upside on euro dollar. Preferably what you want to see is then one more push up in towards the highs, and then for example a dump, take out this liquidity high, pull back in towards the supply zone which is then created, and then for example look for the shorts. However, of course, keep in mind that we are at this time still bullish. However, let's say we push in towards the highs, we see close above this high, then this becomes for example your new swing low. And then we can see kind of like that break of structure, then pull back further shorts with supply created in line with liquidation of this high and hitting that overall stronger area of supply. But yeah, that's pretty much from a daily perspective. Now looking at the 4 hour time frame, 4 hour has been ranging, very boring week last week. As we can see, I have this range trading tool drawn on. Just gonna explain that in a second. I'm looking at the overall market structure for now. We are still bullish with this being your swing low, this being your swing high. Liquidation on this high, then big V-shaped reversal in towards the downside. So we still have this strong area of supply located over here. Last week, we pretty much have just been moving sideways for the entire week. Nothing really that interesting. 4 hours still bullish, so we should still be expecting further upside. Overall, after kind of ranging for such a long period, I do expect a massive move either in towards the up or downside. Preferably, I'm not going to really be betting. I'm just going to be waiting to, let's say, see a hit of this supply zone, then look for short, or a hit of either of these two demand zones, and then look for a long again. So that is it from your dollar on a 4 hour. Now looking at the 15 minute, of course, has just been moving sideways. Overall, what we saw was, for example, this liquidity high located over here, tap in towards that supply, then a further sell off. We had, for example, this sub for the buy, liquidation happening on all of these lows, tapping towards there, then a V-shaped reaction again. So when we see these V-shaped reactions, we know that there's a lot of demand inside of these kind of like pivots. So what you can then see is that price came back in and moved out again. Pretty much if we look at the overall flow of the market over here on euro dollar, and hence why I drew in this range trading tool, what you can see is that the 25 and 75% mark are acting as your areas of support and resistance, and you're pretty much just bouncing in between these levels, right? Hence why if we are ranging, I preferably always kind of want to draw on this tool and use it as additional confirmation for my trades. 50 minute at the moment is still bearish. Keep in mind, we need to see kind of like this high go, and then we can look for longs. For example, in towards this area of 4 hour and 15 minute supply before looking for further shorts. So that's pretty much just it. Yeah, overall, not really as interesting as, for example, Aussie dollar. So that's it pretty much for euro dollar. Just ranging, expecting a big move. But looking at the 4 hour, we can pretty much just anticipate on what's going to be happening next. So let's move over to Aussie dollar. So Aussie dollar pretty much did exactly as expected, right? So we had that area of supply located over here. Overall, the daily time frame is still bearish, so still preferably going to be looking for shorts, especially if we look at how the daily has been moving sideways, ascending, very corrective. 9 out of 10 times you're going to see a big sell-off happen in towards this demand zone. So that is it from a daily perspective. Now looking at the 4 hour time frame, 4 hour has this area of supply which is created by liquidation. As I mentioned in last video, last week, those are high areas of probability or high probability areas to short. As we can see, tap in, tap out, V-shaped reaction, right? Easy as that. Mentioned it last week. Now we're seeing liquidation on this low with demand located over here. So now we're kind of like seeing that push again on the lower time frame. So keep that in mind. Just share that on Telegram, link in the description down below. Overall, looking at your Aussie dollar, sorry. We of course saw a breakout structure, right? So 4 hour overall is bullish from this low in towards this high. However, this breakout structure is not really convincing, especially with the daily time frame being bearish. As we can see, we just saw kind of like a close above and then again straight away a dump in towards the downside. So it seems more to me like a liquidity grab, especially again over here, just grabbing kind of like the last area of supply. And then selling off means that Aussie dollar would want to move down lower in line with the overall daily trend. This is my area of supply that I'm looking for on Aussie dollar to then further short. So yeah, for now, looking at the 15 minute time frame for potential longs, you could look for a long at the moment. Overall, with this pretty much being your change of character over here, this low got broken by this high. Now we would want to see, for example, a pullback in towards this sell before the buy and then look for longs. It is a high probability area of demand due to also liquidation being on this low, and this 50 minute area of supply also being pretty nice. But this, of course, this being your extreme 50 minute area of demand is of course a high probability. So what you can do is kind of like two options. Either you go long from here, that's kind of like the first trade you can take. It's still kind of like high probability for me as the 15 minute swing structure is still bullish. So look for pretty much pullback and then further upside. And then, for example, if we take this high internal breakout structure, look for another pullback and then another long. Or what you can do is that, again, because at the moment internal structure is bearish, this is kind of like your swing in towards the downside. This is your pullback. Wait for, let's say, a new lower high to be formed. Then you wait for another internal breakout structure. Then, for example, because this new high is closer to where we are now than this high, right? Because if this high, let's say, goes, then price is already much further. It's going to be less of probability of a trade to trade further in towards the highs. So what you kind of would want to do is either trade aggressively this first trade, go long, or what you do is that you wait for, let's say, this low to go, then push down and then wait for this high to break, and then, for example, trade the next area of demand that is then created. So yeah, a lot of explaining, but I hope you guys understand what I'm trying to explain. If you have any questions, make sure to ask those inside the Telegram. So that's it from Aussie dollar. Yeah, just overall very, very beautiful sell-off in towards downside, which we pretty much fully anticipated. Was looking for a nice entry upon this change of character over here, kind of like see that pullback. However, really just didn't really pull up high enough, at least in towards this supply zone or this supply zone. So personally, no trade, but still always nice to see your analysis play out. So now heading over to pound dollar, looking at pound dollar overall, looking at it from a daily perspective. Daily, of course, in my opinion, is looking good for a further sell-off. Very choppy price action in towards the highs. Overall, kind of like this double top. What you then see, and I'm not interested in the double top, I'm interested in the fact that there's supply created by the double top, which takes liquidity from this high to preferably see a pullback in towards there and then a further sell-off. But kind of like the second option would be, let's say, taking this high one more time, kind of like seeing that ascending wedge and then further, or ascending channel and then further sell-off in towards the downside. For pound dollar, not really seeing any conviction after this break of structure, therefore not really convinced on further longs for now. Looking at it from a daily, from a 4 hour perspective, I was waiting for this area of supply to get hit. sadly was pretty much similar to euro dollar, just ranging overall for now, kind of like creating liquidity underneath this trend line. So preferably what I would love to see is one more tap in towards supply and then a further sell off back down in towards this demand. That is what I'm looking to trade as of now. Of course, we are still bullish, this being your swing low, this being your swing high. However, overall, just not a big fan of looking for further longs, especially kind of like this being your main area of demand, this sub for the buy. You can kind of see that we didn't really move out of this area of demand. We've been chopping inside of it for a very long time, so there's not a lot of demand left within this sell candle. For the rest, we had this area of demand, but again, yeah, you can just see no real reaction. So pretty much just looking for shorts. If we can take out this liquidity high, push, and then a further sell off, that is what I'm looking for. Then 50 minutes, looking to also short. If we look over here on the 50 minute, overall, if we just point out pretty much market structure, let's say boom, and then again, break of structure, then again, break of structure, then again, break of structure, then again, break of structure here. So this is your high gets broken. So we push up, pull back, push up, break of structure, no break of structure on this high because we didn't close above. So just let me just point it out for you. So this high, then this is your lower low, this is your high, then this is your lower low. Again, very nice short over here in line with the overall trend. Pretty much that was like the best short you could take. Further sell off in towards the downside. Now looking at market structure, this is pretty much the high to break over here. And this is currently, let's say, your swing low. So what you pretty much want to do, or what you can look at, is of course you would say shorts from a 50-minute perspective. But what I would like to see is one more break up, mainly also because I like these areas of supply up higher. For example, this 50-minute area is very nice with this liquidation over here, and also this wick over here taking out these highs. This is kind of like the perfect area of supply, very high probability to take a trade from there, especially kind of like looking from a 50 minute perspective. You would then, for example, have that break of structure. After break of structure, we expect a pullback, then look for those change of characters and trade it down lower again. So a lot of explaining over here, but hopefully overall you guys understand what I'm looking at. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Hope you guys have an amazing day, amazing week. If you have any questions, just let me know. Have a great day. Thanks, guys.